Again. So let's discuss, you know, the topic at hand, which is article writing. The first question that really comes to mind is, why is that the medium? There's so many mediums out there. I know you like a lot of different mediums. You've got a great podcast, et cetera. But why has articles really caught your attention and focus when it comes to this?
All right. So just to be clear, articles are one part or one piece of the whole puzzle. And what I'm going to focus on today is article writing specifically, but it's not the only thing. Let's start at the very, very top. Right? What are we actually trying to accomplish? Well, we're trying to raise equity for real estate projects. So you've got to think about the old way of finding investors. Actually, it's probably the way that most people still do it, right? You join a country club or a foundation or a charity or a board or networking event, Rotary Club, et cetera, et cetera. So why do you do that? Well, you do it to get your face in front of as many people as possible in the hopes that someone will like what they see and be interested in what you have to say, have money, and want to learn more, right? That's basically what you're doing when you do all this networking. Then what happens when somebody puts their hand up and says, tell me more? Well, the mating dance of the lesser spotted real estate sponsor commences, right? Where you wine and dine, you arrange meetings, you produce and print a pitch deck of unfathomable beauty, etc. And you get engaged in this in-person ritual where you get dressed up properly, you put on your best appearance to educate a prospect about your background, your track record, experience and abilities, etc. And then eventually you might pitch a deal, only to find that only 1 in 10 of the people that you actually meet out of the hundreds that you meet at the social events or whatever, these networking events, only one of them might eventually invest, right? It's an enormous amount of brain damage. So all you're really doing when you go through this process is threefold. Number one, you're putting yourself out there so you are visible. Number two, you're providing information of interest and value to a prospect. And number three, you're establishing a relationship of trust with them. And here's some good news. As much as you don't want to go through that dog and pony show from scratch with new prospects every single time, they don't want to do it either. And even better news, actually, the silver lining is that this pandemic has actually accelerated the use of digital media. So everyone is becoming even more rapidly acclimatized to establishing relationships online, which brings us back to why you should write blogs and articles to attract investors. And this is why. It does all three of these three things that you would otherwise do in person, but in one go, it is 1,000 times more effective than the usual rigmarole of in-person networking. It gets your face out there when you write an article. It provides information of high interest and value to your prospects. And by demonstrating that you know what you're doing, it also builds a relationship of trust between the reader, your prospect, and the author. Right? They come to recognize you as somebody who knows what they're talking about. It's 1,000 times more effective than in person. Why? Because instead of being in a networking room with maybe 12 people in it, or presenting in front of a few hundred, right? If you're a speaker, an article can be seen by tens of thousands of people. And importantly, it lives online indefinitely, whereas the speech that you might make will be done and over as soon as you step away from the lectern.